In this video, I'm going to show you how to relieve a lower back bulging disc in 30 seconds. Stay tuned. Hey everyone, Dr. Rowe here at SpineCare in St. Joseph, Michigan. So in this video, we're going to focus on taking pressure off spinal discs in the lower back or the lumbar spine. If you're unfamiliar with a spinal disc, it's like a shock absorber that takes a lot of stress out of movement in everyday life. Like a shock absorber, they can become overwhelmed, and what happens is they tend to then get compressed and bulge out. A bulging disc usually causes a pinched nerve, particularly on the sciatic nerve. So if you have a lot of leg pain, sciatica pain going down the leg, this video might give you relief in as little as 30 seconds. The exercises that we're going to be doing are very straightforward, easy, and they're traction-based. That is pulling motions to help open up those joint spaces and relieve pressure off those spinal discs. So with these exercises, you can pretty much do them at home, at work, anywhere. I'm just going to be using an everyday pull-up band or an exercise band that I got for 10 bucks locally at a sporting goods store. You can also get them online at Amazon. But all of these movements are very safe, they're very effective, and you probably are going to find that it's going to help that bulging disc in the lower back. So let's get started with them. So the first traction or decompression exercise that we're going to do, we're going to start with a therapy band. What I did with the therapy band is I looped it around the other side's doorknob and then closed the door. So it's very sturdy. It's not gonna come back and whack me in the face. I just sit on my butt and then I put my legs, or I should say my feet, right up against the door. Go to a point where it feels like it's very, very tight already. And I position the lower part of the band right on the top of the buttocks right here. You want to make sure that it's going to hit the very low end of the back. And what I do is once I get into that position, I'm just going to simply lie flat on my back like this. I'm already starting to feel a pretty good traction into my lower back. So if you have a compressed herniated or a bulging disc, what this is already doing is pulling on it to help open that joint space up, bring that bulging material back in off that pinched nerve. Only go to your comfort level with these. These should not cause any more discomfort. If they do, please discontinue immediately. But what I'm going to do is just kind of use my feet to press a little bit further with it just to intensify that pull. You can hold these stretches for an extended period of time. You can do it for a couple minutes if you really feel that it's giving you a lot of relief. But once you're able to get into that position, try to start off with about a 30-second hold, relax, and then just do it up to 5 times. If you feel like this right here is not giving you enough of a stretch, you can intensify it by getting back into that very good position and then taking your arms like this and then going all the way backwards with them, just like this. And I tell you what, it feels like a very good stretch into the lower back. It just really helps take pressure off those spinal discs, those bulging discs, and can give relief very quickly, again, in as little as 30 seconds. So this next spinal decompression exercise for a bulging disc in the lower back, you're going to want to do at the edge of a bed. Also, when you start off, put a pillow underneath your hips and pelvis because it's going to allow for a little bit more comfort. So let's go towards the edge of a bed just like this until you feel like only your hips and pelvis are on it, but the lower back is now off of it, because what we're going to use is gravity to put a pivoting point into the lower back to cause some traction into those spinal discs to relieve that bulging disc. So I go to a point where I feel like pretty much the back is hanging off and the hips aren't, and I'm going to go down on my elbows just like this. And when you do this, you're going to feel a really good amount of traction already into the lumbar spine. Those spinal discs are slowly starting to open up and relieving that pressure. Again, with this exercise, you can hold it for upwards to 30 seconds, possibly even longer, as long as you feel comfortable. But if you want to do 30-second bursts, just hold this. What you're going to do then is just kind of push yourself back up, take a little bit of a breather, and then get back into that position and just repeat up to 5 times. But with this one, if you feel like you're able to get even more of a stretch in there, put your arms out as far as you're able to go. Use your fingers to really grab forward, and you're going to feel a very good stretch into those spinal discs. Again, you can hold it for an extended period of time, and then just kind of go back into this position, push yourself back up to give yourself a breather, and repeat up to 5 times. So another variation of a spinal decompression traction exercise that we can do for bulging discs using our bed is to put our pillow at the edge of a bed right here, and what we're going to do is position our upper body and our hips over this pillow while our lower body, or I should say the lower back and the legs, hang off. So you get into a position where you're able to just allow the legs from the hips all the way down to the knees to go straight down towards the floor. This position, again, you're going to feel those spinal discs start to stretch a little bit in the lower back. Gravity is opening them up and hopefully reducing a lot of pressure. You can hold this position up to 30 seconds when you need a breather. Just simply put your feet back down just like this, and you're going to then want to repeat up to 5 times. If you want an even more intense style stretch, we can build into it what's called a sciatic floss. And what I'm going to be using is just a furniture mover. You don't have to have a furniture mover, just use a smooth plate. You can even use a paper plate if you have one around the house. Just put your toes on it right here, and what you're going to do is go back into that position, but what we're going to do is then drive our legs backwards like this. And I go out as far as I can go. And then I hold that position for about 5 seconds. I'm going to then come back like this, and I'm just going to keep repeating that. If you have a lot of sciatic pain from a bulging disc, you know, a pinched nerve, this right here is going to help reduce a lot of tension into that sciatic nerve pathway while also helping to traction that bulging disc at the same time. It's a great exercise. But what I like to do with this one is just nice, slow, controlled movements, holding each end for about 5 seconds, and then repeating up to 10 times. So one of the easiest ways to traction a lower back bulging disc is to find 2 sturdy objects that are about the height of your hips. I'm just going to be using 2 cabinets right here. You can also use 2 chairs as long as they're sturdy and don't have wheels at the bottom. So what I'm going to do is just go to the center of these 2 objects. I'm going to take my hands, grab at it, and then I'm going to go up on my toes to start off with. This right here, you should already start to feel gravity pulling on your lower back to help decompress or traction those lower back spinal discs. Hold this position for 15 to 30 seconds if you're able to. If you're able to go longer, do it as long as it feels good. But if you want a more intense traction into the lower back for those spinal discs, try to then lift your toes up like this so your body is dangling downwards. Hold it upwards to 5 to 10 seconds. If you have enough strength, you can do it even longer, but then just take a little bit of a breather. You want to do these for about 5 full repetitions of just trying to go in there and let gravity do all of the work. So this is another great at-home traction exercise that you can do for a lower back bulging disc. Let's take a large bath towel and put it over a door just like this. We're going to put our feet at shoulder width apart, and then what we're going to do is grab the ends of the towel, and then I'm just going to position my body out from the door a little bit and then try to take my butt towards the floor while I'm holding on to these 2 ends. So I just use my leg strength to just slowly lower myself down. When you do this, the angle should kind of go slanted a little bit. So while you lower your butt, you're then going to start to feel a nice traction starting to form into the lower back. I tell you what, this feels like a very good stretch. The nice thing is that you can use your leg strength to control how much traction you're going to have into your lower back. So go to a point where it feels like a very good stretch. Just keep lowering and lowering and lowering while you hold on to this towel. And once you hit that point where it feels like a very good traction into those bulging discs, you just hold this for about 15 seconds. Use your legs to bring yourself back up and then just repeat that process. When you do this, try to go a little bit further with it on the next time. And then again, hold that 15 seconds, come back up, and then repeat up to 5 times. Give all of these a try and use the one that you feel is the most effective towards those lower back bulging discs. I hope they help. If you liked the video and got a lot of relief, please show us your support by giving this video a like and maybe subscribing to our channel too. If you have any comments or questions, please leave them below. I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Thanks for watching.